Hello, welcome back to Ekidel. And then today I'll be showing you the part 4 of this 16 story building video series. So right now, if you are new on Ekidel, let me just tell you guys that this is what we are planning to do on Ekidel. We are planning to design a 16 story building, and currently we are on the part 4 of this 16 story hotel building that has a swimming pool at the top of the floor here, and also there is also a swimming pool at the I think it's the second floor of the building, as you can see it here. And also we also have basically this is a hot bath swimming pool, and then you can see also that we also have a swimming pool at the top of the roof here of this 16 story building. So basically we promise that we are going to show you guys how to design a high-rise building here on Ekidel, and currently we are on the part 4 of this building design project. So right now the next thing to do right now is now continue, which is now the part 4, and on this part 4 I'll be showing you how to model this this second floor here, the second floor, and then the third floor. As you can see that on the second floor we have a swimming pool at the second floor here, and then on the third floor this cantilever flows all around, as you can see it there, which is not on the second floor. Okay, so right now let's begin for what we have for today. So I will now go back to my model file here. Now on this place right now I will now have to go back to my plan view here. Okay, so on the plan view just now, the next thing I'll do right now is now insert story, because currently we have only story 1 and story 2. On the part 3 of this video, we performed a full, we performed this modeling, and also I showed you guys how to insert cantilever slab, okay? So now on this part 3 now, I will continue to model for the story 3, which is the third floor. So I'll come here again right now, and then we will first thing to do is to now insert story, because we are done modeling this second story, this second floor here, this story 2. So I'll go back to this place right now, building set out, and then come here and then click here and then insert what? Story. Okay, that's fine. So I'll come here and then put what? Insert what? 3, which is story 3, and the height of the story is still 3500, as you can see from the card file here, that the heights of the stories are the same. If you check right now, this is the ground floor, okay, this is the ground floor, first floor, and then second floor. So this is where we are just now, because this software counts from can't see as story 1 and this as story 2 and then this as story 3. So currently now we are on this place here. So from this place now, how to get your height, your headroom or your story height, is just simply subtracting this from this. So by doing that now, you will have that 11,900 minus 8,400 millimeter. That gives us what? 3,500. Okay, so you can see that the height of the headroom is still 3,500. So I'll leave it as it is, and I'll come here and then say generate what? Members as we insert story. So it will copy both the beams and columns and every members into the new story. That is how this product 2022 works compared to how 2018 version works. Okay, so right now you can see that everything now is now copied. We now have story 3. We now have story 1, 2, and 3. Okay, so this is now story 3. If I now look at the 3D view right now, you will now see that we now have story 3 slab here. Now let us now confirm it from our CAD file here. Okay, so from the CAD file again here, let me just do it like this now. Okay, so from the CAD file now, let's now count the story where we are. So from the CAD file now, this place here, which is here, is this level that they are seeing here, and this level here is this story here, and this story that we are now is on this story here. And then this slab that is here, this slab here, is basically this slab that you're seeing now. So we will now have to model this slab, because this slab has a cantilever on this other side, okay? So we will have to model it back, and then the first thing I'll do is to take you guys right now to the plan view of that story, which is basically this year. Okay, so this is now the plan view of the story, but don't forget that we have a swimming pool at the story two, which we have a swimming pool at this at this floor here, which will drop down into the story one. Okay, but I have said that I will model all the swimming pool later. Let me first of all insert all my stories. Okay, so right now let's now move to story three. Now story three is typical from the third floor to the ninth floor. So whatever we do on this third floor now will now be typical onto the ninth floor. Okay, so right now on this place, let's now move on now to this place. Now we have a balcony. As you can see that there is no balcony around this place here, but on the third floor here, as you can see, let me just put it here. We have a balcony here on the third floor, as you can see. And also, we have also have a balcony on this place here, and also on this place here, and also, we also have a cantilever on this other side, okay? That is why this third floor plan is different from the second floor plan, and that is why we have to model it afresh. That is the the third floor, okay? So now, on this place now, I'll just come here and click on the plan view here. Now, on this plan view here, we have already known the length of our cantilever, okay? So, Lord, let me just take you back there right now. So, to know the length of this cantilever right now, I'll just say, din linear, which is dimension. And I'll come here and click at this place here, and then click at this place here. Okay? And that tells me what? It is not directly there. Let me just take it to that place from here to here. Okay, that gives me what 800. So 800 right now is not the length of the what cantilever. Okay, and it flows all the way down from this place down to this place here, and then we now have our balcony slabs around here. Okay, so right now I'll just minimize here. I'll just open the software again right now, and then first thing I'll do is to do what is to offset the what is to offset is to offset this our grid line. So I'll click on this place now. Click here and then copy this grid line. I can choose to copy or offset, okay, and then keep this here first, okay, and then I'll now come here, click on this one now, right click here, and then I'll say what move, okay, and I'll move by what 800 millimeter, and I'll press enter, okay. So right now this is now the point of our cantilever. And I'll come here, since I already have a cantilever slab, I'll just click on this right now, right click here, and I'll say what? Properties, okay? And then, I will now come, once it shows the cantilever slab properties dialog box, I will now come here, everything is already set, everything is set, body load, and then I'll come here right now, and then click at this place here. Now, I've already defined to you guys how we got this cantilever load, so you can watch the part 3 to get that, okay? And I'll click here right now, and then come here, and then click outside here, okay, that's fine. And I'll continue again, then click here again, and then continue all the way down to this column here, and then click here, and then click outside now, okay? So right now, we now have our cantilevers being inserted at this point here. As you can see, you can see that there is a big difference from the second floor here at this edge and at this edge. And that difference is that this one has a cantilever slab, which is serving as a balcony at the third floor here. Why this other one doesn't have, why this second floor and first floor doesn't have a cantilever slab on this area, on this side, okay? So back again right now to our plan view again, to our plan view now, okay? So again, the next thing that is different from this second floor plan and this third floor to ninth floor plan is that it has a balcony on this area and on this area and on this area, and this balcony is also serving as a cantilever, okay? So right now I'll have to confirm the length of that cantilever. So I'll click again. Let me just pause. Okay, so this dimension stuff was not showing, so I just have to set it back for it to show, okay? So right now I'll have to confirm the dimension of this cantilever. So I'll do this right now, click on this dimension here, and then I will now come to this place. And I can see that let me just say from here to this point here. This point is the point of our cantilever. we have what? We have 1080. So 1180, that is the length of our cantilever. But from the grid line, which is here, from this grid line down to this edge, we have what? We have 1100. Okay, so 1100 right now is what we have from the grid line all the way down to this place, and then we'll have 1180 from this place here down to this place here. Okay, so right now the cantilever length starting from the beam face to the cantilever face is 1180, because that is how we calculate for cantilever length. It starts from the beam face all the way down to the other place. That's how this software calculates that. Okay, so right now I'll now go back to the software here, and the first thing I'll do is to do what? Is to now offset. Is to offset first the is to put a grid line first at the edge of the of this place of this beam, and then now move that grid line out to 1180. So I'll move it now. I'll move 1180. Okay, and I'll press what? Enter. Okay, now you can see that I am using ghost grid line or hidden grid lines that don't have bubbles here. So this now becomes our cantilever length for the balcony. So right now again, let me just go and check how this balcony is. You can see that this balcony right now is simply carrying a glass rail. There is no symbol of block wall around this balcony here. Okay, so we are still going to use the load of 5.2 as our dead load, as our cantilever load. So I'll come again right now, click at this slab here, which is the cantilever slab, right click, and I'll say what? Properties. Okay, right click, and I'll say what? Properties. Okay, to get that properties, and I'll come here, cantilever length here, and I'll change to 1180 as my cantilever length, and I'll come here, click on this place here, and click at this place here, and then click outside here, and insert that. Okay, that's fine. So right now, you can see that from our CAD file now, we have just gotten that perfectly done, as you can see it now. Then the next thing now is that we also have the same cantilever at this other end too. So I'll just quickly go here right now, and then do the same thing at this other end from here to here, and then click outside here. Okay, that's fine. And then we now also have the cantilever around this place here. And now this other one now, knowing that we have a beam flowing all the way down, as you can see from what we have here before, we have a beam flowing all the way down here. So what happened now is that I will have to confirm again what is the length of that. Okay, so I'll do that now by clicking on this first, and then dimension, and I'll come again, click again, confirm from the grid line all the way down to this place here. If I still have the same 1.1, that means that it has the same cantilever length of 1180. Okay, so I'll minimize this right now, and then go over to this place. We have the cantilever in between these two columns. Let me just confirm again. Okay, so we can see that we have the cantilever in between these two columns here. Okay, so I'll come back to this place now. We have the cantilever at this place here, and I'll come again, click here, and then click what? Outside here, and then click what? Here. Okay, that's fine. So now let's go and check our 3D view right now to now go and see what we have done so far. So you can now see that what we have just done so far right now, we have just created this balcony cantilevers here, which is this balcony that we have here also, as you can see there. So right now the same thing that happens on this place now happens all the way down to the third floor. Okay, so right now we have just successfully created modeled this story tree, as you can see that. Now let us now go generate the story up to ninth floor. Okay, so by doing that now, you have to come here and then come back to your now don't forget that there is still wall load around this beam here. So before we generate to up to ninth floor, we'll first of all insert wall load on this beam so that at least we are not going to now begin to insert wall load on each of these stories. Okay, so that it will just copy the warload all the way down to the ninth floor. Okay, so right now I'll just copy come here, right click here, and then copy this warload. I've already shown you guys how to insert warload on the part three, so if you have not watched that video, I would say that you should just pause the video right now and then go and watch the part three. Okay, So again, right now, come again back to plan view here. Now, before I do that, I'll first of all go and insert the warload on story 2 because we don't have warload on story 2, and the warloads are basically around the perimeters of the what of the building. Okay, so I'll come here, hold my control key, and select all the perimeters of the building. Okay, I'll select that right now, and then select that again, select this again. Okay, and again, select this and this and this. So make sure you hold your control key so that you can be able to make a multi selection. Okay, click and click, and then we also have a warload around this place here. We have a warload here and then here and also here. Okay, and I'll come now, right click, now I'll do what I'll do, what paste load, and I'll say yes, and then that's it. And I'll go again, go to my story 1. Okay, that's fine, we have all that. And then go to my story 3. So from story 3, now again I'll quickly again copy again, sorry, click again, click here, click here, sorry, click here, remove this. So make sure you don't click grid lines, else you will not see that paste load option. So only copy the beams and not grid lines. Okay, sorry, only select the beams and not the grid lines. Okay. And I'll do this again right now. Sorry, I'm taking the grid lines. That's bad. Okay. And then I'll click here again to take the beam only. And again, sorry, not the grid lines. Okay. So again, and then this, and then this. Okay. And then finally this, and then this. Okay. And I'll come here, right click here, and I'll say what? Paste load. And I'll, okay, that's fine. So if not check the 3D view right now, you will now see that we now have our loads just like this now. Okay, so with this now, we will now have to now generate this story right now. Since we have a balcony, as you can see there, we have a balcony around this place. Okay, let me just confirm that first. Okay, even if we have a balcony here, I think this block here is still carrying a warload because you can see that there is a window here. So basically right now there will be a load on this place. Okay, so I'll just leave the load on the wall here, because if not, there is a principle that once you have a cantilever slab, and if the cantilever slab is carrying a warload, then you have to remove the warload that is just after, that just before the cantilever slab. Okay, so but right now this cantilever slab is a balcony and it's not carrying any warload, it's only carrying an iron rail or a glass frame. Okay, so right now let's now go and insert story up to the 9th floor. Okay, so but before I do that right now, I'll say that if you have not click on the subscribe button, and if you have not liked this video, I'll say you should give this video a thumbs up so that you always begin to see our amazing videos, and also you will be also be able to watch this video series up to the last part, which is the Pi Foundation. Okay, and then also I will also say that if you are a student, I will say that you should share this video to your WhatsApp group chat, or if you are a worker, you guys say that you should also recommend your colleagues and your friends to, so that they also know what we are doing here on Ekidel. Okay, help us to promote Ekidel around the world. Okay, so that because our mission is to share what we know or down to every young engineer. Okay, so right now let's now begin to proceed now to the part 5, which is now to now generate other floors up to the 9th floors. Okay, because from the 3rd floor and to the 9th floor is typical. So right now we are done with the part 4 of this video series. Now watch out for the part 5, which is coming out just immediately after now. Okay, now before I go, I will say that this September is about to go, and we are given 50% discounts on all our products, and also on Ekidel mentorship class specifically. So we are given 50% discount on Ekidel mentorship class. Now I have already explained how the class is, how our class is a live screen training where we have to share our screen by using using Google Meet, or we use Microsoft Teams, and then we will train you about structural design. So if you want to learn more about structural design, I will say that you should not miss this perfect time that we are given 50% discount. So you can just engage on that. After this September, that is all for that. Okay, so right now, thank you so much, and God bless you. We'll love you, and then see you again next time tomorrow. Bye for now.